And just call toll-free 1-800-527-3800. That's 1-800-527-3800. To save $5 in COD and handling charges, use your Visa or MasterCard. Or mail 1295 to Designer Ring Set, Box 8325, West Palm Beach, Florida, 33407.
Entertainment Tonight, weekdays at 5 on TV 12.
He was a talk show host who became bored and disgusted with his job and himself. He wanted to do more than interview celebrities, so he enrolled in medical school and became Tom Snyder, M.D.
Honey, okay. This hurts.
I know, sweetheart. He'll be here any minute now. Oh, Dr. Snyder, thank God you're here.
I'm sorry I didn't get here sooner, but I was at the hospital. I was making myself a ham sandwich. That may sound silly to you, but they got one of those little cafeteria setups where you just make your own. I figured, what the heck? I'll make myself a sandwich. And wouldn't you know it, I couldn't get the damn top off the mustard jar.
Dr. Snyder, would you look at my husband, please?
You know what I think I did? I think I turned myself against ham permanently. I mean, ham and mustard are inseparable. They're like Abbott and Costello or a hot dog in a bun. I'm just going to have to forget it. I'm not going to eat ham sandwiches anymore. What the hell happened here?
Tom Snyder, M.D. He talked his way through medical crises and into his patient's heart.
Yes.
Well, you're going to make a lot of money out of this, right? You'll make a lot of money. He'll make a lot of money. I'll bet he sue the pants off the guy. And I know I'll make a bundle, too, because I'll do the operation for him. What the hell? It's going to work out well for everybody, huh?
Well, I guess.
Maybe we ought to move him.
No, no, they say he shouldn't be moved.
Who says he shouldn't be moved?
Well, I don't know.
Somebody on the crew? What, is that some kind of a union rule?
Oh,
is there a grievance here going to be filed? Come on in here. Move him.
Doctor,
just move him.
Oh, doctor, no.
Johnny Carson could get people moved on his show.
Careful.
Why the hell can't I get people moved?
Expect the unexpected as a talk show host makes his dramatic debut.
What the heck? You may as well be walking.
Tom Snyder, M.D., Thursday at 9 on SCTV.
Tired of ordinary television? Don't touch that dial. SCTV is now on the air. Starring Joe Flaherty, Eugene Levy, Andrea Martin, Rick Moranis, Dave Thomas, featuring Robin Duke and Tony Rosato. Television like you've never seen it before. This is the SCTV Television Network.
We guarantee that you will take...
You get a whole lot in return.
Put your heart in the right place. Join your local Civitan Club, because Civitan Clubs help people.
Grizzly Abrams, he left his home in the city to live in the wilderness he loved, with the wild asparagus, the wild animals, and the wild four-wheel drive recreational vehicles. It was just him in the woods until one day he found an injured turtle and nursed him back to health. He had to use everything he had learned about wilderness medicine to get the turtle back on its feet again. But eventually, Grizzly earned the love and respect of his newfound friend, Snappy. And together they lived and laughed and explored nature's deepest secrets.
You know, before there were ever matches, the Indians used to take two sticks and rub them together like this.
Snappy, I'm hurt bad. Go to the doctor, get help. You going or not? Snappy, I'm not pulling. Come on. Yeah, that's it.
Senor Doc, am I going to leave?
Keith, you're going to be just fine.
Ay, mucho gracias, Doc.
Doc, is he going to be all right?
Pepe, I just said he's going to be fine. I want you to stop playing around with those 12-gauge shotguns, too.
Hey, ay, caramba, last week you almost blew my head off, Doc. Say, Doc, isn't that Grizzly's turtle? What's he doing in town?
Well, say, that is Snappy. I think he's trying to tell us something.
Maybe Grizzly's hurt.
Yeah, he wants us to follow him. Come on, let's go. We gotta help him out.
Taramera, Juanita, Juan Taramera.
Hey, Doc.
Yeah.
I think we should pull over. He's going so slow, caramba.
Yeah, you're right, Keith. Pull over for a spell. In fact, you can pull over for a week the way this...
Say, Doc, the engine, she's boiling over. I'm a...
Oh, great.
Look at that. The radiator's boiling over.
What is that, anyway?
Hey, Doc, the radiator's boiling over.
I can see that, Peppy. Ah, caramba, Doc. She's on fire, Doc. Caramba, what are we going to do?
No!
Hey, Doc, look. Hey, why don't you check his pulse, Doc?
What?
You think you can save him, Doc?
You idiots! He's dead! It looks like he's been dead for some time, too.
Oh, he's dead.
And we have that revolting reptile to thank. Well, boys, you know what I can go for right about now?
What's that, Doc?
A nice big bowl of turtle soup. Gee, look at him go.
Caramba, look at that.
He's cut out. He's heading for Baker's Pass. Let's get him. I know a shortcut.
Hey, Keith.
Huh?
Where do you get turtle soup out here?
Grizzly Abrams will no longer be seen in this time slot. But tune in next week for the premiere of the Doc, Keith, and Peppy Show.
The tiny Republic of Togo continues to taunt the Soviet Union, and... I don't know where Earl is, but I'm sure he'll have some major items for you tonight on the SCTV News.
SCTV welcomes you to Crazy Crafts with Molly Earle.
Well, last week we did a lovely show on bingo bags, you know, where you put your little chips in them after when you're playing bingo. And we had so many cards and letters saying, Molly, Molly, let's have some more shows on those bingo devices so that we can make them in the privacy of our own home. So today, we have just the woman to show us how. Now, this woman knows more about the game of bingo than the Pope himself. Now, I've personally seen this woman play 30 cards, smoke a cigarette, drink a pop, yap to the dame next door, and still have time to play the game. So let's have a big warm welcome here for Miss May Sparks.
Right here?
Well, there you are, May.
Well, there I...
Well, here you are.
Where do I...
Come on, just sit, stand here. Can we have a... Now, I can't wait any longer here, May. What is that you got around your neck?
Well, Molly, it's something I like to call a bingo drop can.
Bingo drop can.
Well... It's just made from an ordinary coat hanger, as you can see, and a tin pie plate. And, well, I use it when I'm playing bingo, And move that shoe.
Yeah.
All right.
All right. Now, can we get a close-up on the bingo drop can? Yep, there we are. Look at that.
And I'm playing a lot of cards, and I'm going B12, B14, like that.
Yeah.
And then I just made it because I didn't have time, B12, to be taking a cigarette out, so I just let the ashes fall in the pie plate any time they want to. And then when I'm all through with a cigarette, I just let it drop, like that.
Look at that.
From a soda pop can, and it's just out.
Well, that's brilliant is what it is. Right?
Well, it really
is. That's brilliant. That
it
took
really
like a large brain to think of that.
Well,
how did you think of it? How did you think of this idea? What did it? What happened? What was the process?
Did I think of it?
Yeah. What?
Well, I just saw the coat hanger in a tin pie plate.
Well, that's something else, isn't it? May, one more thing I gotta ask you. Is it true that you sat beside Omar Sharif at Monte Carlo?
Well, I did. And he ordered 2 bingo drop cans. I just hope he pays up.
Well, I do too, May. He's 1 Kellon Bray, if you ask me. Well, that's it for Crazy Crafts for today. Please come back and visit again.
Join Molly next week and see her build a bingo robot.
I'm Floyd Robertson. Get out of those cheap Jimmy McNichol hand-me-downs and get over here. You're supposed to be a newsman.
I'm a damn good newsman, Floyd.
You're a damn good buffoon. Now get over here. Sorry, ladies and gentlemen, we're experiencing lobotomy problems. Please bear with us. Tonight's top story, the tiny Republic of Togo continues taunting the Soviet Union into battle. In his strongest statement in recent weeks, Togo President Ayub Benzwell hurled personal insults at Soviet Premier Leonid Brezhnev, calling him a, quote, commie tippy-toed pansy, unquote. He also triple-dared the Soviets to try and invade his country, claiming failure to do so would mean that the Soviets were, quote, nothing but cow chips stinking up the face of the globe, unquote. Now, political experts agree that the Togos are inviting invasion because of a failing economy, but underestimated the Soviets' tolerance to verbal abuse. Claim one high-ranking Soviet official, quote, it's fun to step on a bug, but it's no fun to scrape the mess off the bottom of your shoe, unquote. Earl?
You know what your problem is, Floyd? You have no vision. You have no concept of the times we're living in.
Earl, just read your news item.
This is the 80s, Floyd. You've got to roll with it. You've got to skate with it. It's a sign of the times. And as newscasters, as professional media journalists, I feel it's our responsibility to reflect those times, even if it means disco roller skating out to do the news.
Earl, for heaven's sake.
Luckily, I am still young enough and hip enough to pull it off. The kids identify with me, Floyd. But you, you're getting old, Floyd. I think you're a little too old for this job.
Earl, that's enough.
Oh, aha. Hit a tender spot, did we, Floyd?
Earl, you moron. Let's discuss this after the program.
Au contraire, Mr. Senior Citizen. I think we should discuss it now. I think our viewing public has a right to know if their favorite newscasters are young enough to have a tap on what's going on in the 80s.
I think the only thing they'd like to have a tap on is your mouth.
I'm proud to say, ladies and gentlemen, that I'm a youthful, zesty 33 years old. Floyd, how old might you be?
And that's the news.
No, that's not the news, Floyd. How old are you, just for interest's sake?
Well, I'm a zesty 30-ish.
30-ish. 34, 35.
No.
36. 37, 38.
Crimes against the elderly are always traumatic.
Coming to SCTV, an experience in live theater with the novel production of Death of a Salesman, starring George Carlin.
Did you ever notice when you're out on a date, you worry about small things, like if you got a booger in your nose?
DeForest Bones Kelly.
Brain. There's something wrong with his brain.
Margaret Hamilton.
Hi, my pretties. Let's have something to eat.
And featuring Ricardo Montalban, Death of a Salesman. Watch for it.
Hello, I'm the Reverend Hugh Betcha, and welcome to my night gallery, entitled Hugh Betcha's Night Gallery. This man you see behind me is Bob Schmenge. Now, Bob is a lonely, pathetic, stocky type fellow who just returned home from having a bad haircut. Well, on his way home, Bob purchased a record.
And that record is going to launch him into a nightmare world.
Yes, it's going to be the world of Hugh Betcha's Night Gallery. Let's watch it now.
Be the night. Tonight's the big night. I guess you'd like to see old Bobby with his collar down, huh? Maybe a couple of buttons open. Yeah, you get that up like that. How'd that look? Nice haircut. Just go on like that. There. brother gave me this. This will be gorgeous. Look at that, huh? Huh? That's so good. Yeah. Tonight, baby.
I'm your date for the evening. My name's Brandy. What's your name?
Schmengi, Bob.
Richard? Oh, that's a wonderful name.
And it's Bob.
Do you mind if I call you Rick?
I guess so, sure.
Oh, Rick, this is a fabulous apartment.
Thank you very much.
Oh, and look at that view.
Basement apartment.
Do you mind if I sit down?
Not at all. Help yourself.
Oh, Rick, I would just love something to drink.
Oh, well, we've got some scotch.
What have you got?
Scotch.
Do you have any vodka?
No, don't
well,
vodka.
Then I'll have the scotch. Oh, that's enough. Rick. Why don't you come and sit down next to me? I don't like to sit all alone on this big couch.
Ooh, you're on the couch, huh? I'll just come on over.
Oh, hurry up.
I'll put your drink over here. Sorry.
Oh.
Didn't mean to sit on you.
Richard, you are so good looking. What do you do for a living?
I'm unemployed right now. I don't really have a job.
Oh, that sounds so exciting.
As it's days, I guess.
Oh, look at those nuts. Do you mind if I grab a handful?
It's kind of really neat.
These are really good. I just love party nuts.
Party nuts? Oh, yes.
Hey, what about that drink?
Sure. Here you go.
Oh!
I'm sorry.
Oh! Look what you've done.
I'm sorry.
I just want this dress. Nobody. Well, get your hands off of me.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean to.
Stop it.
Let me help you off with that.
Stop it. Oh, well, I guess I'm just gonna have to take this darn dress off. Oh, look at Richard. It's soaked right through to my panties. I guess I'm just gonna have to take them off, too.
Oh, yeah, I guess you don't want to.
Why don't you join me, Richard?
Huh?
Well, take your pants off.
I don't know.
Oh, don't be shy. Oh, please, Richard, please. Oh, please, take them off.
Come on.
Oh, look at those long legs.
Thank you. Oh. I feel kind of silly. Oh. Excuse me, just for a second. Hello? Hello? Hey, Paul? Sue, hi. I didn't expect your call. Yeah, I'm tied up right now. Can you call me back? Call me back.
Who was that?
That was right. That was my mother.
Oh, you call your mother Sue. Well, look, do you think I'm stupid or something? That was another woman, wasn't it?
That wasn't another woman, Brandy. Honest, that was just a
trick, playing along two women at the same time.
I wasn't,
well,
I swear
I tell
to
you,
God.
I don't have to take this kind
it
of
was my mother,
a long
Brandy,
life
please
from
give
you
me another chance.
I'm getting out of here. That doesn't matter. I'm getting out of here. No, I'm... Oh, Richard, it's my husband. If he finds you like this, oh, Richard, please, hide, Richard, hide! In the closet! Go under the couch, Richard! No, no, that's the worst place. I'll look out the window, Richard!
I don't want to go!
Please, he'll kill us both! Oh.
All right! What have you done with my wife?
I didn't know
was your wife. I didn't know you were married.
Tom, put your clothes back on.
Tom, don't do anything crazy.
Don't shoot me. Please don't do it. I didn't know you were married. I didn't know it was your wife.
That's a mistake that you're going to die for. 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 Die for.
Well, there you have it. Bob Schmenge was caught with his pants down.
And he was killed.
Yes, he made that one mistake. He entered the nightmare world of Hugh Betcha's night gallery. Good night.
Turn to Eyewitness 12 News for the complete...
Buckle your safety belt.
SCTV now signs off with Mel Torme.
Oh, say, can you see by the dawn's early? Pardon me, boy, is this the Chattanooga choo-choo? I've got my share, and just travel to spare. Oh, once I built a railroad, made it run, kept it running on time. Once I built a railroad, now it's done. Brother, can you spare a, rocket's red glare? The bombs bursting in air gave proof through the night that our flag was still tall and ten. And yes, lovely, the girl from Ipanema goes walking, and when she's walking, our flag was still there. Oh, say, does that star-spangled babadabadanner yet wave for the land of the creepers, creepers? Where'd you get those peepers, creepers, creepers? Where'd you get that home of the most beautiful girl in the world? Picks my tie out, she eats my candy, she drinks my brandy in the home of the red.
And now the Canadian anthem, as selected by Bob and Doug McKenzie.
Oh, Canada. Glorious and
beneath its snowy mantle.
Yeah, you got a real good snowmobile.
Won't you take me into Winnipeg Town?
Sunday.
What do you find in Alberta today?
The maple leaf forever.
No face, and it pass our day. Sitting around,
nobody riding on the maple leaf.
And Canadian, every time.
Taking care of business.
Give a child a chance to grow up.
The weekdays at 10:30 on TV 12.
This year, SCTV shines with Elvis Presley and Lou Costello.
Well, I found a new place to dwell. When it's down at the end of all this
pain,
I bring you food to
you. Know something, Elvis? I don't even have the sports department. I can know all the players' names.
Yes, sir, you do.
Are you the fellow knows all the players?
Yes, sir.
Well, who's on first?
That's right.
Now, who's on first?
Who is the name of the man on first?
First baseman.
Who?
Guy playing first.
Who?
Fellow's name.
Who?
What's his name?
The name of the man on first is who?
I'm not asking you who's on first.
I'm telling you who's on first, sir.
Who's on first?
Who? Get this straight. Who is the man playing first base?
What are you asking me for? I can't believe this. You know who's on first?
Yeah, that's right.
Abbott!
Who's on SCTV? Elvis and Costello. What's the name of the show? Elvis and Costello. Thursday at 9 on SCTV.
Tired
of ordinary television? Don't touch that dial. SCTV is now on the air. Starring Joe Flaherty, Eugene Levy, Andrea Martin,